Hi, sometimes you want to hear another voice. We're going to make our iOS apps talk using the AV Speech Synthesizer and Text-to-Speech. The AV Speech Synthesizer is a class that takes text and produces speech. If we're looking to add speech for maybe a dozen or so things in our app, we're probably better off recording normal human voices. If we have lots of dynamic things we want the phone to say from text, and we want it to sound a little like a robot, AV Speech Synthesizer is where we want to be. The voice of the synthesizer is locale specific. That means we can give the voice an Australian accent. The choices for the languages to use are determined by the language your phone is set to in your settings. For example, mine is English, so I can choose accents from the US, Ireland, Australia, and South Africa. If the text you want to say and the voice aren't in the same language, the speech synthesis will fail. A voice must be downloaded to our phone as well. None of the code will work until we add a voice. We can check to see what voices are available in the settings. It's in General, Accessibility, Speech, and then Voices. We give the synthesizer an object called an AV Speech Utterance. This is the bit of text we want the synthesizer to say. This can be a single word, phrase, a sentence, or more. The utterance is also configured with a voice and some parameters to customize how the voice should work for this utterance. The configuration parameters control the pitch of the voice, how fast the voice speaks, how loud, and any pauses we want between the utterances. The reason each utterance gets its own voice and configuration parameters is we might want to slow down one sentence for emphasis, or maybe we want to bounce between voices to handle a conversation, and so on. In our app, let's make our app talk when we push a button. The UI is just a button that says speak, nothing fancy. So the first thing we want to do is add a synthesizer to our app. The AV Speech Synthesizer is in the AVFoundation. We'll import AVFoundation and then create one synthesizer for the entire app. Next, we'll want to handle the button press. The first thing to do is create the text we want our app to say. We'll just create an AV Speech Utterance and pass in the text. The speech utterance needs a voice. Normally, we'd create a voice and then set it to that voice. This doesn't appear to work in iOS 9, so this is a bit of a hack, but we can iterate over the list of available voices on the phone and select one that way. We'll do this once in view did load, and we'll search for an Australian accent. Here's the fun part. We can configure the voice to sound how we want. We can change the rate of control how fast the voice is speaking.
How can you tell which one of your friends has the new iPhone 6S Plus? How can you tell which one of your friends has the new iPhone 6S Plus?
The pitch multiplier controls how high the voice we want.
How can you tell which one of your friends has the new iPhone 6S Plus? How can you tell which one of your friends has the new iPhone 6S Plus?
The volume controls how loud or soft the voice is. Its default is 1. The AV Speech Synthesizer is really a cue. We can pass the synthesizer many things to say, and it'll say them in order. The pre and post utterance delays control how much delay we want between the utterances. We can think of this as controlling how much of a breath the phone takes between sentences. Finally, we tell the synthesizer to speak, and we're done. That's all there is to making it speak. We'll likely also want to control our UI as the phone speaks. For example, we might want to highlight words as our phone speaks them. We can make our view controller an AV Speech Synthesizer delegate and handle different events. The main methods available in the delegate are did start speech utterance, did finish speech utterance, and will speak range of speech string. Did start and did finish are pretty obvious. These are called before the utterance is started and finished. Will speak range of speech string is called before each word in your utterance is spoken. It's a bit tricky because the method gives us the entire utterance every time and an in its range so we can calculate which word is about to be spoken. It'd be nice if they gave us a swift range, but that's what we get. All right, so that's how we convert text to speech on iOS devices. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments. Or if you just want to say hi, if you like the video, like and share. New videos come out every week, so make sure you subscribe. You don't want to miss a video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.